Hey guys, hope you're having a good day. We're currently about 10 days away from Clone Wars Season 7, and we couldn't be any more excited. In this video, we're going to be ranking our top 5 clones in Star Wars. Obviously, there are many clones in the show and universe in general, so comment down below your personal opinions. Also, please subscribe for future Star Wars content. With Season 7 of Clone Wars coming out, we are beyond excited to release content pertaining to the show. We plan on breaking down and reviewing each Clone Wars episode when it comes out. Alright, I hope you enjoyed the video, and let's get into it.
Alright, first off, there are numerous other clones that we considered when making this list, and basically all the clones are cool characters that we love. Here are some honorable mentions. First, we have 99. 99 was a deformed clone, and despite his physical challenges, he was still a true soldier who had as much will as any clone, and he made a very sad sacrifice during the invasion of Kamino. Next, we have Heavy. He was a member of the Domino Squad, and we saw Heavy's unique backstory and his close relationship with 99 while on Kamino. He would later sacrifice his life for the rest of his squad to live. Now we have Commander Gregor. Gregor's story was very unique, and we never really saw a clone commando before. His last stand to free D Squad was super cool, and to see his appearance on Rebels was a very nice surprise to see that he survived after his thought to be death and Order 66. Next is Commander Thorn, who was a shock trooper on Coruscant. His last stand and sacrifice is what makes him so cool because even after being hit with blaster bolts, he continued to fight to the death. Lastly, for honorable mentions, we have Waxer and Boyle. These two were always together, and their relationship with the child Numa on Ryloth made them very empathetic. They found the child scared and lost, so they helped her stay calm and became friends with her. This showed how good of hearts Waxer and Boyle had, and Numa even refers to them as brothers.
Lara! Lara! Lara!
Sir, what is that she keeps calling us?
Nera. It means brother.
Plus, Waxer's death on Umbar is very sad and emotional to see.
Alright guys, coming in at number 5 on our favorite clones list is going to be CC-2224, also known as Cody. He's the leader of the 212th Attack Battalion, and fought alongside General Kenobi during the Clone Wars. The Jedi respected him greatly, and a main reason for his high ranking came from Obi-Wan's referral for him to be promoted. Commander Cody always followed orders, especially this one.
Commander Cody, the time has come. Execute Order 66.
Yes, my lord.
No, but all jokes aside, he's a very trustworthy soldier, and his impressive performance on the battlefield earned him the right to co-lead Squad 7, an elite group of clone commandos. Even being a part of this squad is impressive, let alone being a prevalent leader in the group. Cody went on to lead many missions with Squad 7, adding to his already decorated career.
Alright, coming in at number 4 we have CT-1409, better known as Echo. Echo was a member of the Domino Squad, and would later achieve the rank of ARC Trooper in the 501st Legion. He got his name because he would always repeat orders during his training. Echo would often fight alongside Fives when seen in combat as well, and he always had aspirations to be an ARC Trooper, since he was a clone cadet on Kamino, which of course he would later achieve. While at the Citadel, Echo was believed to be killed in action, but he survived and was captured by the Separatists and tortured. He remained loyal to the Republic, and was later rescued and joined a squad called the Bad Batch. I look forward to seeing these episodes, exploring more about this in the upcoming Clone Wars Season 7, and that is why Echo comes in at number 4.
Alright guys, next up we have CC-3636, also known as Commander Wolf. He served under Plo Koon in the 104th Battalion's Wolf Pack. Wolf was one of the few clones who was able to remove their inhibitor chip, and he is seen in Rebels alongside Rex and Gregor. One of the coolest things about Wolf is the color scheme of his armor. One may think it's gray simply because the color is gray associated with wolves, but there's actually more to it. On Wolf's first mission with Plo Koon, their mission was to destroy the Malevolence, a Separatist cruiser. However, the mission went horribly wrong, and it left almost all of the Wolf Pack dead. Wolf was lucky to survive alongside a few other clones, and Plo Koon as well, so he decided to change the Wolf Pack's colors to gray in order to honor his fallen soldier's sacrifice.
Coming in at number 2, we have CT-5555, also known as Fives. He was another member of Domino Squad, and was soon achieved the rank of ARC Trooper in the 501st. Fives was seen in numerous main battles and arcs during the Clone Wars. He was greatly respected by the leading clone of the 501st, Captain Rex, as well as Jedi Anakin Skywalker. Fives always stuck up for what he believed in, and always did what he thought was the right thing to do. We see him stand up to Krell on Umbara when Krell tries to make Fives do things he knows isn't right. Especially in Season 6, Episodes 1 through 4, when Fives does everything he can to try and uncover a plot to destroy the Jedi because of the inhibitor chips he found inside all the clones. He is probably the clone who thought for himself the most, which is why he was so close to stopping Palpatine's plans to overthrow the Jedi. His death while trying to reveal the plans of Order 66 was one of the most sad and emotional deaths in Star Wars. He stood for what all clones would want to be, and that's why he comes in at number 2.
Alright guys, coming in at number 1, we have CT-7567, also known as Captain Rex. Rex commanded Torn Company within the well-known 501st Legion. He was second in command along Anakin Skywalker and can be seen fighting alongside the Jedi in many different Clone Wars arcs. Similarly to Wolf, Rex was also one of the few clones to remove his inhibitor chip. We get to see him fight in both Rebels and Episode 6 of The Force Moon of Endor. One of my favorite episodes involving Rex is Season 2 Episode 10, Deserter. In this episode, Rex has been injured in battle and is forced to stay at a local's farm for the night. He runs into a clone deserter and former soldier, and their dynamic throughout the whole episode is very interesting. The deserter makes Rex realize what he's missing by living his life solely as a soldier, but Rex knows what the battlefield is where he wants to be. This episode gives us insight on how much Rex cares about his brothers in arms, yet also showed his mercy by him not turning in the deserter. In conclusion, Rex is close to, if not the most screen time of all the clones, and for good reason. He's a great leader. He proves time and time again that soldiers can in fact think for themselves and be their own people, and he fights valiantly alongside both the Republic and the Rebellion. This is why he's our favorite clone.
Alright, that concludes this video. Comment your favorite clones and leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more Star Wars videos. Thank you for watching, and may the Force be with you.